Glazing works well, both acrylics and oils. I'm using oils. Color is transparent earth orange. Here I'm beginning to get the glaze ready, and I'm thinning that down. Just pressing that. I tried to tape the thing onto the glass palette. It didn't stick very well. Beginning to apply a glaze, and I thinned it. Well, I thinned the glaze down with some liquid, and liquid mixed with the gamsol, and I thin it down and just take a little bit of the thin down paint and put that on. That's what the glaze is made. So you don't need like really a lot of thin down paint on the brush. Just a little bit of the thin down paint. And then apply that in there as the glaze. Or that is, at least to begin with, I might want to keep it pretty thin down, and very little on the brush, just so I don't go too heavily. But since I'm using a transparent color, you can go rather thickly on there, and it can look really nice. Here I'm sort of applying a second coat, kind of just wet into wet glaze. Just putting it in a little thicker, heavier glaze on there. And where I just said wet into wet, I'm referring to the glaze, of course. The painting underneath was, I let dry that for, was fully dried before applying the glaze over that, of course. Or, of course, also you could, it's possible to carefully apply a glaze over wet paint. It doesn't work exactly the same. You can sort of do that. You could sort of apply a glaze over wet paint. It's worth, but that's not what I'm doing here. This is, of course, over top of a dry painting, applying a glaze. And in the case of this painting, I wanted to go back in. Glaze is still wet, and I'm going back in with some white paint, bring up contrast and whatnot. Now the golden color and how the glaze catches into crevices of the underpainting, it gives it the look of a Rembrandt. And at this point in this painting, I'm gonna mess around with it a little bit to see what kind of glazing effects I would get. They're wiping it back a bit, and then I'll reapply a little bit thicker. And at this point, put the painting aside, and it's either done, or maybe I may still retouch a tiny little thing when it dries. And then now on to project number two. And the color I am using for this one is Permanent Carmine. So it'll be the same thing, just taking the medium and thinning it down quite a bit. And thinning it down a bit more, just to be cautious and not apply way too much, and then just testing it out in the corner there, see how it goes. Begin applying that stuff. You know, generally, it's using a very small amount of paint, really, and spreading that all around. And this is far as it can keep spreading it. Maybe want to take some more and maybe want to go thicker. I've got a little more paint on the brush and whatnot. And after continuing on a little while more, I left it as just the final glaze, just like that. And so I would add also that when I paint on the underpainting, I'd gone very white, and very overly whitish, because at that point I decided I was going to do a final overglaze to bring out, which darkens that whitish color to a more vibrant, rich glaze color. So now I give you not just one glazing project, not just two, but a third glazing project, which will be this polar bear. I'm going to glaze him with phthalo blue. So as you might guess, I can go ahead and start applying some glaze over my dried painting. I want to thin that down a good bit and just take a little bit on the brush. Maybe test how it goes on there. After applying the glaze over this one, I still wanted to retouch the bear's head. So I put some more colors out, and I just use the same colors from the other projects, which was some white and that transparent orange, earth orange, and the permanent carmine. These colors should work just fine on this one. Just went in with the pure white. Lights. Continue on. I want to just work on his head. Brow and whatnot. It's like. As I said, I just wanted to retouch his head a little bit more, bring that out a little nicer, paint it a little better. Like his nose and whatnot, his snout, let's call this part, the snout of his nose. Just bring that out a little bit is all I'm saying. Back in, right back into the glaze with these opaque paints back over the glaze. Here I'm even go back in another like glaze, wet into wet glazing. Such a thing. Well, now there is. Just can put a little bit of a warmer glaze right back over top of that. So I wanted to bring it out a little darker there and thought that color would look nice. And here I'm scratching back into that with the palette knife. So I like scratching at the painting, but the paint back off sometimes. More likely to scratch at a painting with a palette knife than apply paint with the palette. So, enough rambling from me. We're going to conclude this video. Thanks for watching. If you liked it, give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos. See you next time. Bye-bye.